Hello friends, in this video we are discussing about types of mortar. Mortar is very useful in the stone masonry or brick masonry to work as a homogeneous mass. Now what are the different types of mortars that are available? First, it is classified on the basis of following terms. First is bulk density, then kind of binding material we are using, then it comes nature of application where we are applying it, and then special requirements. So on this four basis we divide your mortar types. So let us talk about the first type, that is by bulk density. According to the bulk density of mortar in dry state, there are two types of mortar. First is your heavy mortar, which have the bulk density equal to or more than 1500 kg per meter cube. So we are talking about the bulk density in dry state. If it is dry state, bulk density is more than or equal to 1500 kg per meter cube, that is known as heavy mortar. And second is lightweight mortar, which have the bulk density less than 1500 kg per meter cube. Next is kind of binding material we are using. Based on it, we have a lime mortar or lime surki mortar, that is also known as surki mortar, or we can have mud mortar, a cement mortar, gypsum mortar or gretsch mortar. So depend upon the material you are using, we can divide the materials into six categories, and the different type of material we can use is lime, cement, surki. Generally we use lime or cement. The lime mortar. Now what is lime mortar? In this mortar, lime is used as a binding material. Therefore there are two types of mortar. First is your fat lime mortar. And a fat lime mortar is mixed with a sand in the ratio of 1:2 to 1:3. This mortar cannot be used in waterlogged or damp areas. So fat lime we cannot use in damp areas. Then second is hydraulic lime mortar. There are two types of lime, we already know. That is fat lime and hydraulic lime. So the mortar is divided into two subcategories. In the hydraulic lime mortar, the hydraulic lime is mixed with sand in ratio 1:2. This mortar should be used within 1 hour of mixing. The mortar is sufficiently durable and gives more strength in damp situation. So this mortar is sufficiently durable and it will give you more strength in damp situations. So hydraulic lime mortar we can be used in damp situations, but fat lime mortar we cannot use in damp situation, and both are mixed with sand. As you can see, these are the type of lime mortars we use here to fill the stone masonry. Second is lime surki mortar. In this mortar, lime is used as binding material and surki as a replacement of sand. So in the previous lime mortar we use only sand and lime, but here sand is replaced by surki. That's why the name is lime surki mortar. The surki powder should be so fine that not more than 10% should be retained on 90 micron sieve. If you sieve through it, 90 micron sieve, IS sieve, the fineness should be like that. It should not retain more than 10% over 90 micron sieve. Such fine surki we have to use. It is used for ordinary masonry work in superstructure and foundations, but it cannot be used for pointing and plastering. That is the main point. It can be used for masonry work, but it cannot be used for plastering and pointing purpose. Over here, as you can see, it can be used for this masonry works, stone masonry, but it is not useful for plastering and pointing works. Next come is your cement mortar. In this mortar, cement is used as a binding material and sand in a ratio of 1:2 to 1:6. This mortar possesses high strength and water resistance capability. It can be used for plastering, foundation, underground structures, tanks, etc. Cement mortar is generally useful for all type of waterborne structures, where you can use for plastering also, foundation also, then your underground construction also, and the tanks also. So this is very useful and can be used in the ratio varying from 1:2 to 1:6, cement and sand. Next come gauge mortar. To improve the quality of lime mortar and to achieve the high strength, sometimes cement is added to the lime. And this mortar is known as the gauge mortar, in which lime also there and cement is also there to increase the strength. The proportion for cement lime may be in the between 1:8 to 1:6. So it is known as also cement lime mortar. This makes mortar economical, dense and strong because lime and cement both are present in it. It is used as binding layer or thick brick wall. It is also used as a bedding layer, or it is used as a thick brick wall. And next come is your gypsum mortar. This mortar is prepared by using gypsum as a binding material and sand. It is used in Egyptian times. Gypsum mortars are used in pyramids, as we know the Egypt pyramids. And these pyramids, generally, we are used for the gypsum mortars, which because at that time gypsum was available cheaply, because at that time lime and cement was not there. So they use gypsum with your sand, and this mortar is used to fill the gap between the stones, which is used for the pyramids. Gypsum mortar will have low durability in damp conditions. In Egypt, as we know, there is no damp condition. It is dry, very dry. So we can use gypsum easily over there. But in regions like Mumbai, Maharashtra, where the rainfall is very high or the moisture content is very high, we cannot use this gypsum mortar. Then come some special mortars. First is your fire resistant mortar. Then packing mortar. Then we have sound absorbing mortars, X-ray mortars. Now let's talk about the fire resisting mortar. This mortar is prepared by adding aluminous cement to finely crush brick powder in the proportion of 1:2. So it will use what? Alumina, cement and the brick powder in the proportion 1:2. This mortar is fire resistant and can be used as knacklining, ovens and fireplaces, where we have some fireplaces where the burning is more, or the industries where we deal with the fire, we can use such type of mortar, which is fire resistant mortar. Next is packing mortar. To pack oil wells or special mortar possessing high homogeneity, water resistant, pretending setting, etc. have to be formed, and such mortar are called as packing mortars. The varieties of packing mortars are cement sand, cement and loam, cement sand loam. So packing mortar may be of these types. It's generally used for your oil wells. Then comes sound absorbing mortar. Now these are some new mortars. To reduce noise level, this plaster is prepared by adding lightweight porous materials as aggregate in cement. As we know, we have to use for your cinema halls or some theaters, we have to use what? Sound absorbing barriers. So in which the walls are plastered by using the sound absorbing mortar, and which is prepared by adding lightweight porous materials such as aggregates to your cement. The bulk density of this mortar is 6 to 12 kN per centimeter. The bulk density of this mortar is 6 to 12 kN per meter cube. The aggregates used are pukics, then cinder or polyether etc. Such lightweight aggregate we can use, or the porous aggregates we have to use in this material. And last is your X-ray shielding mortar. These are generally used for X-ray rooms. High density aggregates with binding material are used to prepare this mortar, in which we have to use now high density aggregate. And whereas in your previous type, we had to use the porous aggregates. Due to heavy density of materials, the X-rays cannot penetrate inside the mortar and act as shield. So these are generally useful in hospitals where we design the X-ray rooms. In this video, we have discussed about different types of mortars, their applications and their materials, and some special types of mortar also, how they are useful and how they are prepared. Thank you.